Good morning, everybody, respected judges, seniors, and my dear friends. I am going to talk a case which is referred by a top retina surgeon from the Mahalakshmi, Mumbai. It's a multiple times operated because of a nucleus drop, IOL drop. You can see the decompensated cornea with a typical scar where the visualization is poor. First step, we are scraping the epithelium, and Amarsa's invention, Choka AC maintainer, is placed for go ahead with the whole procedure. And we create the scleral flaps 1 millimeter behind the limbus and vertically in both the sides. As the visualization is very poor, we are trying to use the endo-eliminator and trying to do a thorough anterior vitrectomy and trying to separate the vitreous strands in the AC. Then using a blunt instrument, we are trying to strip the Descemet's membrane along with the endothelium. As we are trying to remove that, we see there are a lot of adhesions of the scar tissue into the iris and gently trying to separate, and with the help of a micro scissors cutting the iris adhesions gently as far as possible. We are trying to preserve the iris tissue also, and all the adhesions are cut and visualized very well through the endo eliminator. Once this is cut completely, we will try to remove the scar Descemet strip along with the endothelium. And now once this is removed, the next step, we want to see the intraocular lens. As you see, it is subluxated there, the intraocular lens. By the handshake technique, we are trying to hold the haptic from the main incision and trying to hold the tip of the haptic and trying to externalize it. As a lack of time, I'm going to skip the glued IOL technique in this, and trying to bring the trailing haptic out and see to that it is Chariot's pocket, it is inserted to that. Now the third step is that we want to do the single pass 4-through pupilloplasty. Here, through the straight needle with the 10-0 nylon, we have inserted to the iris and brought it out, and the thread by the railroad technique, and trying to mobilize the iris everywhere and see to that we try to get a rounded pupil, and the knot, the loop is pulled in. At the same time, throughout the procedure, if you see, the trocar AC maintainer helps us to continue with the surgery, and the four loops are taken and pulled to each other, try to get a rounded pupil. Once the iris thing is repaired, we'll see whether any other vitreous strands are there by injecting an air bubble, and see there are no vitreous strands, and with the help of a blunt instrument, we are going to check any other remaining strands are there. We are going to gently remove it and see to that once it is done, the whole bubble is there, and we are trying to repair the fourth step in this, the cornea, trying to create a type 1 bubble, and with the help of a sharp needle, we are injecting the trypan blue into the bubble and trying to remove the PDEK graft of the 80 micron thickness, and it is kept inside the normal any other injector of the intraocular lens, and it is inserted to the anterior chamber, and with the help of a blunt instrument we are trying to stretch it, and it gets attached, and the air bubble is placed underneath, and the glues are placed, and the flaps are closed, and see to that there are no air wound leak or air leak, anything like that. Now this is a preoperative picture of the pseudophakic bullous keratopathy and a 15 day postoperative picture. And this patient was very extremely happy at the 45th day with an extreme good vision. Thanks a lot for AMASA for the great opportunity.
Thank you.